Question center, so today I'm going to explain our 11th standard physics 12 chapter thermodynamics part 3 video, and this is the last video I explained about first rule of the first theorem I explained about thermodynamics. There we proved that proved that the delta thermodynamic is equal to pressure and is equal to the work done and internal energy. Next, thermodynamic process. So a thermodynamical process is said to take place when some changes occur in the state of thermodynamic system. The first is isothermal process, a process taken place in a thermodynamic system at constant temperature. Is called as isothermic process, and it is very slow process. So work done is equal to 2.3026. So therefore, after differentiating P and V is equal to constant, we have dp by dv is equal to minus P by V, and dp by dv is equal to P. Like that only, adiabatic process are very fast process. That is slow process, this is fast process. So the following the process follows Poisson's law, that is according to which PV is equal to TV is equal to TY by PY minus 1 is equal to constant. Here work done in an adiabatic process is W is equal to NR by TI minus TF by Y minus 1. So P1 V1 minus PF VF Y is equal to minus 1. So Ti and Tf are initial and final temperature. Sudden compression or expansion of gas in a conductor with perfectly non-conducting wall, and suddenly bursting of tube of a bicycle tire, propagation of sound wave in the air, and gases. Isobaric process, a process taking place in a thermodynamic system at constant pressure is called as isobaric process. And molecular heat, so here internal energy du is equal to nc into dv, so dq is equal to, that is the thermodynamic is equal to du, the internal energy plus work done. So therefore the work done is equal to pdv, that is the molecular heat capacity of the processor is cp and dq, and cp and the dq is equal to ncp and dt. Next is isochoric process. So a process taking place in a thermodynamic system at constant volume is called as isochoric process. So next is dq, that is the dq is the thermodynamic is molecular capacity for isochoric process is Cv, so volume in constant, so dw is equal to 0, so n is equal to work done by heat supplied. So work done by the cycle can be computed from the area enclosed cycle on Pv curve. So that's where volume elastic of gases. So there are two types of elastic of gases, that is isothermic thermal modulus of elastic Ps is equal to P. And the second one is the adiabatic molecular of elastic ET is equal to YP. So therefore ratio between isotherm and adiabatic modulus is ES by ER is equal to Y is equal to CP by CP. So the second law of thermodynamics, the first law you learned there, second law of thermodynamics is, the second law of thermodynamics gives the fundamental limitations of efficiency of heat engine and the coefficients of performance of refrigerator. It says about the efficiency of the heat engine can never be unity for 100%, and the heat released to cold reservoirs can never be zero. So Kelvin statement. So it is impossible to obtain continuous supply of work from my body by cooling it to a temperature below the coldest of its surrounding. We cannot cool it more, and we can make metal to do work, and Clausius statement is, it is impossible to transfer heat from a lower temperature body to higher temperature body without using an external agent. So it is impossible to transfer the energy heat from lower temperature to higher temperature without using an external agency. And Planck's statement is, it is impossible to construct a heat engine that will convert heat completely into work. It is impossible. So entropy is a physical quantity that remains constant during a reservable adiabatic charge. So that is constant during the reservable adiabatic charge. So heat engine is a device which converts heat energy into mechanical energy. So heat engine consists of three parts, that is source of heat, work substance, source of heat at high energy, and sink of heat at low temperature. So therefore work done by total amount of heat absorbed, N is equal to Q2 by Q1 is equal to 1 minus T2 minus T1. So therefore Q1 is heat absorbed from the source, Q2 is the heat rejected in the sink, and Q1 and Q2 are the temperature of the source. And heat engine are of two types, that are external combustion engine, internal combustion engine. In external engine, fuel is burnt a chamber outside the main body. Fuel is burnt in a chamber outside the main body of the engine. And in the internal, in this engine, fuel is burnt inside the main body of the engine. Inside fuel is burnt, but in external, fuel is burnt outside the engine. And in this practical life, thermal effectivity of a steam engine varies from 12% to 16% in the external, and internal is from 26% petrol engine, and diesel engine is 40%. What is Carnot cycle? So Carnot is a device and an idle cycle or operation for heat engine. It is an idle cycle or operation for heat engine. And a Carnot cycle contains the following four factors, that is the isothermal expansion, that is from AB, it is isothermal expansion, and adiabatic expansion, that is BO, and isothermic compression, that is CD, and adiabatic compression, that is DF. So the net work done per cycle by the engine is numerically equal to the area of the loop of the loop represent the Carnot cycle. So theta t by theta 1 is equal to t2 by t1. So therefore efficiency of the cycle is n is equal to 1 minus t2 minus t1. So refrigerator of a heat pump is a device used for cooling things, and it absorbs heat from sink at low temperature and rejects the large amount of heat it absorbs the heat from the sink. It is a cooling thing that absorbs the heat from the sink at the low temperature and rejects the large amount of heat source at the high temperature. So it is written as V is equal to Q2 by W. So therefore Q2 by Q1 minus Q2. So therefore it is equal to T2 is equal to T1 minus T2. So therefore relation between efficiency and coefficiency of the performance, that is B and N, it is represented. So B is equal to 1 minus N by N. Like this is the loss formula. So okay friends, I think you understand the thermodynamic completely. So okay friends, like the video, comment on it, subscribe my channel, and questions and for more video. I will see you in the next video explaining the other chapter of your Planck's standard. So till then, take care, have a nice day. Bye my dear friends.